This is BBC Newsline, the headlines this Wednesday evening. All Northern Ireland schools are to close from Monday.
The societal and economic impact of this measure will be enormous, as parents have to adjust their routine to deal with this unplanned long-term closure. This is unprecedented.
But this is a very anxious time, a very worrying time, and I think it's important that we work together to provide as much assurance to our families, to our people out there who are really, really anxious about what this means and how they're going to be able to respond to it.
The First and Deputy First Ministers also...
Schools will have a two-week break over the half-term holidays starting Monday. The minister insists it will not be extended.
Schools will reopen on the 2nd of November. That's what's been agreed by the executive last night. That's what will happen.
And we'll speak to the Deputy First Minister live on the programme.
Another school closure? We've already been closed for 5 months. How long is this going to last for? November. December. Our school carol service, the kids will be so disappointed. I don't think that's going to happen. Actually, where's last year's carol service? I think I saw that somewhere. Ah, here it is, a Christmas celebration. I wonder who'll be doing the solo this year.
Once in royal David's city stood a lowly castle shed where a mother laid her baby in a manger for
everyone. I'm very sorry to say that we will have to cancel our annual carol service this year with all of the rules and regulations from the Department of Education regarding COVID. We simply can't do it. It's so disappointing for the children. But what I was thinking, with all of your wonderful technological skills, that perhaps there is something that we could do virtually with the children to make Christmas as normal as possible, that we could send out to the parents so that they could sit at home and at least enjoy it from there. What do you think?
Yes, sounds like a good idea.
Absolutely, we could do that. No problem.
Excellent.
Hello, Carrickfergus Model Primary School. I'm sorry, unfortunately this year we're only able to hold our carol service due to COVID. However, we are working on a virtual carol service and that will be with you soon. No problem at all. Thank you now. Bye-bye.
Boys and girls, pencils down.
I have something very important to tell you.
Coronavirus, as you know, has changed our world dramatically.
It means that a lot of things in life now need to be done differently, P6.
We were so disappointed that Beauty and the Beast couldn't happen in March.
So unfortunately, our carol service won't be able to take place either.
In the format that it usually does. However, we are going to record our own virtual carol service.
We're going to go on a journey of discovery to try and establish the real meaning of Christmas.
We're going to explore what lies beyond Santa, snow and stockings. Does that sound good?
Time of the year.
Mine too, by far.
The presents, the hot chocolate, Santa, the snow. I just love it all.
My mom says that with all the madness of COVID this year, the whole world will maybe slow down. And we'll actually think about the real meaning of Christmas for a change.
Santa?
No. Mom says there's more to it than Santa. Cool as he is.
What does she mean?
I've no idea. But I do have another idea.
Sounds dangerous. What's that ribbon?
We're not having our usual carol service this year, right?
Right.
Well, this afternoon, we're supposed to be going on a journey of discovery. Remember? Why don't we all go on our own little adventure around all the classes to see what they're up to for this virtual carol service and try to discover for ourselves what my mum means by the real meaning of Christmas.
Mr. Trussell would never let us all in at once, and we can't all need the toilet at the same time.
I know! Get him talking about football, and once he's on a wall, we'll all sneak out. He'll never notice.
Great idea.
Super.
Sounds brilliant.
I am not so sure.
Perfect plan.
Okay, so you can see that because this is an isosceles triangle, you're therefore able to work out y, and then x minus y. Reuben.
Mr. Trussell, did you watch the Liverpool game last night? What about that disallowed goal? It was never offside. It was a goal every day of the week.
Reuben, that's not quite our numeracy. However, we can come back to numeracy because that is an excellent discussion point. Well done. Now, I thought you might ask that. Okay, so I had a little something prepared just to show you why.
Now is our chance.
You can see here that when Alexander Arnold has the ball, Tom, into your seat. Now, Tom, this.
Quick, let's head out to P5 first. I'm not so sure this is a very good idea.
Follow me.
Virtual carol service.
We hope this recording finds you and your friends and family safe and well.
Unfortunately, you can't be with us in person to celebrate Christmas in our school this year.
COVID has stood in the way of many important events this year already.
But we are not letting that stand in the way of celebrating Christmas.
We invite you to come with us on our journey today as we aim to discover
and celebrate the real reason for this magical season.
And it's about more than stockings.
It's about more than snow.
It's about more than shopping.
It's about even more than something.
That's very hard to believe.
Our story begins over 2,000 years ago in a little town called Nazareth.
Let's explore.
Our Bible reading tells the story of an angel called Gabriel who appeared to a young lady called Mary. Mary lived in the town of Nazareth and was pledged to be married to a man named Joseph.
The Bible reading is taken from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 to 38.
God sent the angel Gabriel to the town of Nazareth in Galilee with a message for a virgin named Mary. She was engaged to Joseph from a family of King David.
The angel greeted Mary and said,
"You're truly blessed, the Lord is with you." Mary was confused by the angel's words and wondered what they meant.
And then the angel told Mary,
"Don't be afraid. God is pleased with you and you will have a son. His name will be Jesus. He will be great and called the Son of God Most High. The Lord God will make him king as his ancestor David was. He will rule the people of Israel forever and his kingdom will never end."
Mary was still confused and asked the angel,
"How can this happen? I'm not married."
The angel Gabriel answered,
"The Holy Spirit will come down on you and God's power will come over you. Your child will be called the Holy Son of God."
The angel Gabriel also told Mary that her relative Elizabeth was going to have a son, although she was old.
No one thought Elizabeth could ever have a baby, but she was going to have a son 3 months later. The angel Gabriel declared, "Nothing is impossible for God." Mary, still in shock as such news, responded,
"I'm the Lord's servant. Let it happen as you have said."
Then the angel left her.
Mrs. Falconer, Mrs. Boyd's P5 class will now perform for us our first carol, Midnight.
Quick, let's not miss it!
Beautiful.
I love Christmas.
Let's see what P6 is up to next. Come on!
To pick up where P5 left off and investigate in Luke chapter 2 what happened next to Mary and Joseph.
Remember that Mary had been visited by the angel Gabriel and given the news that she was to become a mother.
We find Mary and Joseph shocked, but also thrilled and excited at the prospect of becoming parents.
The angel's visit had prepared them in some way, though we must remember that things were very different and difficult back then.
Mary and Joseph did not have the same type of freedom that we perhaps take for granted in our part of the world today.
Mary and Joseph's country was occupied.
This meant that there were Roman soldiers making sure that people followed the Roman law.
The man in charge of the Romans was Emperor Caesar Augustus.
He took over Rome shortly after his great uncle Julius Caesar died.
Caesar Augustus issued a decree that census should be taken off the entire Roman world.
Mary and Joseph would have to travel from the town of Nazareth in Galilee
all the way to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because Joseph belonged to the house and line of David.
This journey would be made even more difficult by the fact Mary was heavily pregnant and ready to have her baby.
Mary and Joseph set off on their long journey, probably carrying a few belongings and some food and water.
Perhaps they had a donkey.
But the Bible doesn't tell us that they did. Eventually, the way we covered reached the town of Bethlehem.
They began to knock on doors to find somewhere to stay because they were exhausted and Mary was about to have her baby.
Hello, excuse me. Could we possibly have a room for the night? We have travelled a very long way and the time for Mary's baby to be born is getting so close.
Sorry, we don't have any room, I'm afraid. We're completely full up.
Why don't we try out the street? We could get somewhere to stay for the night.
What do you want?
Good evening. Do you have anywhere for us to stay for the night? We've travelled a very long way and we're completely exhausted.
No, we do not. We're full up. Can't you read the sign?
Oh, why bother us at this time of night?
Sorry to bother you. We'll be on our way now.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
This is Mary, and she is about to have a baby. Do you have anywhere for us to stay for the night? Please, we are truly desperate.
Don't you realise? It's the census. Everywhere is full up.
Sorry, we don't have any space for you. We are really sorry. We'd love to help if we could.
Oh, Joseph, what are we going to do? We're too late. Everywhere is full up. I'm so weak and tired. Please get us somewhere for the night.
I will.
Mrs. Hutton's P6 class will now lead us in the singing of our next carol, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Quick, let's go!
Little town of Bethlehem, but still we see you now. your teacher know you're in here?
No, we're just on a mission to find out what the real meaning of Christmas is. That's all, I promise.
Boys and girls, what are you doing here? It's not your library time, it's P5's library time. You shouldn't be here.
We're on a Christmas journey of discovery. Please don't tell Mr. Trussell you've seen us. We're learning lots.
Welcome back to Bethlehem, where P6 left off for us in Luke chapter 2. Mary and Joseph were unsuccessful in their search for someone to stay and were slowly losing hope.
They were exhausted, hungry, thirsty and tired.
Nearly at their wits' end, they came to a small, humble-looking dwelling.
They knocked and waited, and at last the door opened.
Excuse me, sir. Can we stay here tonight? Mary is about to have a baby and we are exhausted as we have travelled so far to get here for the census.
I've no rooms as such, no, but you look desperate. If you don't mind the animals, you can stay down with them.
It's cramped and smelly, but you look as if you need the rest. It's really all we have. We're sorry.
Oh no, thank you so much. I would be truly grateful for anywhere at all that you could give me to put my head on for the night. I'm so very weak and I just need some rest. Among the animals is perfect. Thank you, sir.
And so Mary and Joseph find somewhere at last.
In a humble little stable in Bethlehem amongst the animals.
There was no cradle in such a place.
No more nice warm bedpost or pillows.
No teddies or blankets.
And no doctors or nurses to help.
So Mary laid baby Jesus in a manger.
And that was how the Son of God was born.
Thank you.
The Son of God was born in the lowest of lowly surroundings.
With no fuss or ceremony.
He lay peacefully at animal's feeding trough.
With his loving mother and proud father looking on.
The breathing and snuffling of the animals in the stable carried on in the background.
The creatures totally unaware that they were the sole witness to the birth
of the Son of God. How inconceivably incredible.
Mrs. McCulloch's P5 class will now listen to singing of Away in a Manger.
Whoa, 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 whoa! Guys, should you lot not be in class?
We don't have time to explain, Mr. Niles. We're on a mission.
We're on a mission to discover the real meaning of Christmas.
I have no time to waste. Santa will be here soon. Come
don't
on!
Don't tell Mr. Castle! Please!
Kids.
Thank you.
Christmas like in your house, boys and girls?
Christmas in my house is chaos.
Everyone is so busy buying presents and making sure they don't miss anyone out.
There's all the rushing about to get the food shopping done and to make sure we've enough to eat.
There's a turkey to buy and Christmas pudding to make.
And all of our school are to fit in as well. It really is difficult.
The jobs that people did when Jesus was born were often quite different from the jobs that most people do today.
Some people were shepherds and cared for their sheep up on the hills.
Let's continue our Christmas story from Luke chapter 2 verse 8, where P7 left off for us.
On the night of Jesus' birth, there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks.
The fields were on some high ground next to the small village of Bethlehem.
The night was one of those lovely, calm and beautiful nights where the sky is crystal clear.
In those days, there was no noise from cars or airplanes, and there was no light pollution disturbing the night sky.
Surely the shepherds must have wondered, in all the beautiful stars hanging in the heavens, everything was totally calm.
Suddenly there was a dazzling light, and an angel of the Lord appeared to the shepherds, and the glory of the Lord shone around them.
The shepherds were terrified, but the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people.
Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you.
He is Christ the Lord.
You will know who he is because you'll find him wrapped in cloths lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth. Peace to those on whom his favour rests."
As soon as the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds hurried off in search of the newborn baby.
They found him wrapped in cloth, lying on a bed of hay, just as the angel had said.
The shepherds knelt in wonder and told Mary and Joseph what they had been told.
Then the shepherds returned to their sheep in a state of great happiness. They praised God and said wonderful things about him to all they met.
Everyone was amazed at what the shepherds had to tell.
The shepherds must have wondered why God had chosen them to be the first to see the newborn Saviour of the world. Everything had happened exactly as the angel had forecast.
Miss Kirkland's P7 class will now lead us in singing a beautiful carol related to this section of the Christmas story. We have found him.
Thank you.
I'm learning lots today.
Quick, I'm sure we've lots more to discover. Where to next? Up to P6?
Christmas is such a special time for the giving and receiving of gifts with the ones we hold dear.
This exchange of gifts reminds us of the real Christmas story when the wise men visited the newborn baby Jesus in a stable in Bethlehem.
We pick up our Christmas story at Matthew chapter 2.
Sometime after Jesus' birth, wise men from the east arrived at King Herod's palace in Jerusalem and asked,
"Where is the one who's been born King of the Jews?
We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him."
When King Herod heard about this, he was worried, and so was everyone else in Jerusalem.
King Herod brought together the chief priest teachers and the law of Moses and asked them,
"Where will this Messiah be born?"
"In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for that is what the prophet has written."
Herod called the wise men secretly and found out from the exact time the star had appeared. He said,
"Go to Bethlehem and make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report back to me so that I too may go and worship."
So the wise men set off. Still following the star which appeared to move ahead of them, they followed it until it came to rest over the place where Jesus was.
Underneath the shining star, you travel far. into the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary and bowed down to worship him.
Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense and myrrh.
Gold, the most precious and noble metal. It doesn't rust or tarnish and stays bright always. The true gift for our king.
Frankincense. Burnt to release a scent and smoke, a symbol of life and rejuvenation.
Myrrh. Used in the embalming process to prepare the body after death.
Jesus had now been acknowledged, not just by the shepherd, but by the wisest of the wise.
Mr. Catterson's P6 class will now lead us in the singing of the carol We Three Kings.
On the move again!
I've heard about a new king being born somewhere in Bethlehem, and
I don't like it. I will not have a threat to my royal throne. This new king is in trouble. Even if I have to kill all the baby boys in the area, there shall be no king but me.
The wise man grew concerned about Herod's request, and at night they had nightmares about what he might do.
King Herod must have been desperate to hear news from the wise man, and he waited impatiently for them to return.
But he did not come back to his palace. Their dreams had rightly made them suspicious of King Herod.
They knew he would think nothing of killing the baby, perhaps them too, so they went home by a different road.
Herod was angry. In fact, he was furious.
But an angel of the Lord was on hand to make sure that Jesus was kept safe.
After the visit of the wise men, Mary and Joseph probably had no idea that they were in danger.
But as they slept, an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream and said,
"Get up! Hurry and take the child and his mother to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you to return, because Herod is looking for the child and wants to kill him."
When Herod realized he had been outwitted by the Magi, he was furious.
He gave orders for his men to kill all the boys in or near Bethlehem and were 2 years and younger.
But that night, under the cover of darkness, Joseph took Mary and Jesus and quietly left Bethlehem.
The family journeyed to Egypt, where they stayed until King Herod died.
Mr. Trussell's P7s now lead us into the singing to celebrate the good news of this light in the darkness with Rejoice With Us.
All class, let's join in!
Thank you.
reflect on the Christmas journey of discovery we've just been on, let us now take time to respond by talking to God in prayer. Let us pray.
Dear Heavenly Father, we join with millions of people all around the world and throughout history to celebrate Christmas.
Please help us as we have fun this Christmas to remember and to be thankful for the real reason behind this wonderful season.
Your gift of Jesus to the world.
Today we give thanks for Jesus as we see in him a love that lights the world.
We give thanks that his birth and earthly life are an inspiration to us all, and we ask that you help us journey life by his example.
May the love of Jesus, shown by his birth, consume us, not just now, but every day beyond the festive season.
Forgive us, Lord, that it often takes this big occasion at the special time of the year to bring us back to realizing how much you love us.
Forgive us, Lord, for we have not always loved you or others. Please help us to show love to all those around us.
Lord God, thank you for all we have and shall receive this Christmas, and help us to remember those who are not as fortunate as we are.
Please help us to be generous with our kindness to others, not just at Christmas, but all year round.
Thank you, God, that you call us your children, and that we can call you our Father and speak to you openly and freely.
We pray for children like us around the world and ask you to bless them.
Father, thank you for your peace that passes all understanding.
We pray for anyone in our school family who is struggling with life at this time.
Please would you send them your peace, and may they know the closeness of your love this Christmas.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for our wonderful school.
We thank you that we can learn and grow together in a supportive and safe environment
where we are cared by all those around us.
Thank you for our Carrickfergus Model Primary School family.
We pray for our teachers and all the staff that work in our school.
May you grant them rest over the Christmas holidays, and we pray that they will come back safely alongside us for all that lies ahead in 2021.
Lord God, as we reflect on what has been a truly unique year, full of uncertainty and fear, we thank you that you are steadfast and unconditional in your love for us.
We thank you for our National Health Service and for all the staff who courageously work long shifts under demanding conditions and putting themselves and their families in danger in the fight against COVID-19.
We pray for all those who have lost loved ones this year. We pray that you comfort and soothe them as they come to terms with their loss. May they know a real sense of your peace.
We pray for our political leaders and all those involved in the decision-making processes at this time as they attempt to guide us through the coronavirus pandemic. May you grant them wisdom and knowledge as they make crucial decisions that affect us all.
We pray for all those working tirelessly to create a vaccine for coronavirus. We pray that they'll be successful in all their attempts and that this worldwide pandemic can be brought under control really soon.
Lord God, we pray all of this in your Son's precious name, our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
This Christmas, let us remember that God gives his most important gift, the gift of his Son, Jesus Christ. Let us reflect today on what God would like to receive from us this Christmas, the gift of our hearts and souls to serve him in truth and spirit.
We're now delighted to be joined by Reverend White, who will share his Christmas message with us.
He lives in Bangor. How are we supposed to get to Bangor?
Ribbon, we're not. By the wonders of technology, we are.
Hello, my name's Reverend Ken White, and I'm delighted to be part of this virtual carol service. Can I just say at the outset, a very happy Christmas to Mrs. Miller and all the members of staff and the boys and girls, and for all the effort that's been put in to make this virtual carol service possible. Great job. Things are really different this Christmas. Things are very different this Christmas, aren't they, everyone? I've really missed not being able to come along to your assemblies, saying goodbye to those who left P7, say hello to the boys and girls of P1 who are all new, and just be able to pop in from time to time at things like Harvest. It just has been very, very different this year. It's hard to believe only a year ago I was able to walk on the stage and say hi to everyone who joined us this time last year. And the word that I think describes all of this is change. Of course, some things are always changing, aren't they? Maybe this year you've had a change of classroom. Maybe you've changed house at home. Maybe you've changed your smelly socks. Maybe you've had a change and met new friendships. Change isn't always a bad thing. It's all around us. And look what's changed for me. I've now become a grandpa. And this is my grandson, AJ. At least they didn't call him B&Q. But AJ actually stands for Andrew Jr., as his dad's Andrew. And this is him. And so not all change is a bad thing, is it? Well, AJ eventually did get changed. I think that's what was wrong with him. And he's safely tucked up in bed. But when I was at the model school today, just looking around, I noticed that amidst all the things that are changing today and all the changes that happen on a regular basis, even though it's now 45 years since I was a wee boy at Model Primary School, there still stands a huge tree standing tall at gates that are still the same. Yes, they probably had a lick or two of paint, but just like outside walls around the school, the playfield, which can I mention I scored many a good goal in for the model, the shelters, and the playground. Some things remain constant and don't ever change. Like this big fella.
Ho, ho, ho! Ho, 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 ho! Hello, everybody! Hello, everybody at Model Primary! And all the mummies and daddies! Hello! Ho, ho, ho! Oh, I'm looking forward to get all your toys to you there in Carrickfergus and all around there. I've got my workers up in Lapland. They're working so, so hard. Ho, ho, ho! And hello to the teachers and hello, Mr. Spielberg. I mean, Mr. Catterson, you've done a great job. Ho, 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 ho! Happy Christmas! Oh, as you can see, I've eaten quite a lot during lockdown. Ho, 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 ho! But I'll be all right. I'll be ready for Christmas.
Or like having presents around the Christmas tree.
Oh, I love presents under the tree, don't you?
Especially the ones that say, to Ken. Oh, I love, oh, great for me. Or all the lovely carols we traditionally have sung for centuries. Who doesn't like all the lovely food? Some things just don't change, especially this. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, which is Christ the Lord. The message of Christmas is a message that has never changed. And in the midst of all of the things that have happened, and some of the things boys and girls have been very scary on television, the Bible says, fear not. Because God is with us, Emmanuel. And from God to us, like a gift, the Bible says, a Saviour, Christ the Lord, has been given. May you discover what it is to open that gift and receive a peace amidst all the changes and the love and the hope this Christmas time. Happy Christmas.
So you can see there that the reason when Firmino drops in, creates the space for Salah to break the offside trap, and that then, of course, is the reason why that is 100% a goal. Does that answer your question there, Ruben?
Yes. Thanks, Mr. Trussell. I was listening to every word, and I totally agree. Thanks.
I hope that you have enjoyed our virtual carol service this year. My thanks go to everyone who worked hard to make it happen. Our boys and girls are so talented, and I'm delighted that they got a chance to perform. I am also incredibly proud of how the children have coped this year. They are a real credit to their parents and to us as a school. At this time of year, we are encouraged through whatever faith we have to reflect on the past year, but to also look forward with hope to better days. So as a school community, we look forward to those better days ahead, and we hope that all of our families are able to celebrate Christmas and enjoy many happy times together. Happy Christmas, everyone, and God bless.